Since then, officials have been considering it. They've drawn up this report, and it was this piece of scrubland around a mile or so from the stadium that Mr. Pemberton says he could have used to bring the plane down in an emergency.
And the water then billowed out onto the floor here and into several other classrooms as well. It's not quite the water world the teachers here have been hoping to be learning about.
The trams that you would usually catch on those lines will be replaced by buses instead. With me to explain a bit more about what's happening and why is Philip Purdy from GMPTE. It's estimated that'll save £30,000. Now that's a lot of biscuits, but the cutbacks don't stop there.
It's been hard, like we had to cart hay up the roads because like we've not been able to like get vehicles up and down the road, so it's been hard work.
There we are. I did one, he did the other five.
I've been sick every time I see my mum because it was seen her in that state. And then I went back in hospital, and then they had to come home because he said they'd do an operation on me as an emergency, or you need to go home. And then within a few days, I had a breakdown.
If she had been brought home a fortnight earlier, we'd have still had her here. We're convinced of that.
Well, it's been 24 hours since I've put the two pictures up of the girls in their pants on my profile, and already I've had 91 friend requests. Three of those are girls and the rest are men aged between 14 and 23.
At this point, we took Fionn out of the investigation. Despite knowing her age, the comments she got from other users were of a much more sexual nature, mainly from boys. One of them had asked for her mobile phone number. We gave him an office number and he sent 24 texts within 3 days, some of them in the early hours of the morning. We'll be passing his details on to police. What would you be doing to try to help the people there who are struggling so much to find work?
Well, I think there are two things. First of all, people who are in work, we've got to try and keep them in work.
So, for ordinary people watching this, are tax rises for them, in your view, inevitable?
I'd love to be able to avoid that. I'm going to work very hard to try and avoid those tax rises on middle-income people.
We've heard only in the last few days Gordon Brown telling his MPs that the election is very much winnable, and we've heard Labour saying that all the Conservatives are offering is an age of austerity. What would you say to that?
Well, if anyone is bringing about an age of austerity, it is Gordon Brown.
The Prince in particular was keen to speak to those enthusiasts who keep the old engines working. This museum is home to one of the world's largest collections of working steam engines, one of the oldest energy technologies that was developed, and the Prince has used his visit here to address scientists looking at new energy sources. When they got back here, the disagreement turned physical. Kevin Hargreaves punched his wife several times and then went upstairs. When he got to the bedroom, he emptied some petrol out of the lawnmower, which unusually was kept up there, and then set light to it. The flames quickly engulfed the room. Here at Manchester Airport, flights were cancelled from early this morning. Snow completely covering the runway, planes simply unable to move, and so too the passengers. Brian and Joan say they do want to stay close to Bolton, but that's not going to stop them travelling. South America's on the destination list, as well as standing at the foot of Everest. With this big win, the world really is at their feet. Fibres inside the finger that are pulling it inwards need to be separated from the rest of the finger, but inside there's a bundle containing a nerve and an artery, and around that is a special casing that must be protected. And experts told this inquiry that's a crucial part of the procedure. In this case, that bundle was cut and the entire protective sheath around it removed. Patient A's finger was left more bent than it was to start with, stopping him from playing the organ. Air traffic control gave permission for the plane to fly between 1,000 feet and 2,000 feet. One witness says he was as low as 800 feet, but the judge rejected that, accepting Mr. Pemberton's evidence that he was no lower than 1,500 feet and may have been as high as 1,800 feet. That would mean he could glide without power for around 3¾ kilometres. Salford's been a Labour stronghold since the 1940s. This was the state of the parties in 2005, Labour polling almost 58%. This year, the constituency is bigger, taking in Eccles as well, another area that's voted Labour for decades. Nine candidates are expected to stand, including three independents.
If it was just a protest, I personally wouldn't be interested in standing.
Well, here we are just outside Saddleworth. It's -4 here at the moment, and the farm that we're heading to is probably a mile or so that way, if that. But this is as far as the Jeep will come with all of this snow, so the rest of the journey is going to be on foot. Hello, welcome to Channel M Today. Your bank holiday weekend starts here. Coming next, I'll have the day's news from across Greater Manchester. It's just coming up to 4:30. Welcome back to Channel M Today. Our main headline this afternoon, it could soon be much quicker to travel by train from Manchester to London. Every year, Lim Round Table organise a charity duck race. Not real ducks, but plastic ones, of course. It attracts people from miles around, and we've been along to find out why. Those are today's headlines, and that was the lunchtime news. Much more on all those stories with Andy Crane in the evening news from 5 tonight. But from me and all the lunchtime team, have a very good afternoon. Bye-bye for now.